Hey guys, we left off on chapter 17. It's called Our Future So Bright, We Gotta Wear Chains. We both kept getting madder and madder, angrier and angrier. You try being called Pottymouth and Stoopid by everyone from the age of 4 on. It'll make you bitter, so will sucking a dozen lemons dry in a day. But Michael and I did that only once because nobody on our block had a spare buck to buy it. We had to do something with all those lemons. At least we had a pound of sugar, too. This one time, we were walking home after school with Anna, and we started imagining what the rest of our lives would look like. You're right, Michael. Lemonade is way better without all that water. Think old prison movie in black and white, then add a very spooky dun 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 soundtrack. Skiffer jeeber dee. I probably should have brought something besides a spoon. It's leftover from the lemonade stand drying up there. Our future didn't seem very bright. In fact, it looked pretty grim, the color of dirty dishwater, something Michael and I figured we'd better get used to since we seemed destined for careers as dishwashers or busboys. By the way, can girls grow up to be busboys? Because Anna needed a job too. Fudging school cafeterias where we'll end up, said Michael. You could be a chef like David's grandpa, Johnny, said Anna, who still clung to the shred of hope because she hadn't been Anna Britannica as long as Michael and I had been potty mouth and stupid. You could open a gourmet corn dog stand. No biffle busting way, said Michael. I'll be wearing a ball cap, asking fluffernuckles if they want fries with that for the rest of my life. And what if they want onion rings with that? I said, why doesn't anybody ever ask if I want onion rings or tater tots? I think I'll grow up to be a super smart homeless person, said Anna. I could give people little known facts for spare change. The Three Musketeers bar was originally split into three pieces with three different flavors, vanilla, chocolate, and strawberry. Or how about Alaska is the only state that can be typed on one row of keys? If you're homeless, I said, Michael and I could be homeless with you. We could start our own cardboard condo complex. That'd be so cool, said Michael. We could all have boxes next to each other. I'd like a refrigerator crate, I said. Those things are sturdy. I want one of those wardrobe boxes, said Anna. The kind moving companies have with the rod to hang stuff. I want one of those too, I said. I can use the rod to dry my socks on a rainy day. Of course, if it's raining. I guess our cardboard walls would bend. Doesn't matter, said Michael. A box like that with a rod would be awesome-tastic. Like living in a closet, but without any stinkerific mothballs. My foster mom's mothballs everything. It's why I smell like an old person's attic. Now all three of us were cracking up. And after we're homeless for a while, I said, we'll probably go to jail. The donkey duking big house, said Michael. Anna looked thoughtful. But behind bars, we'll learn a trade. License plate printing, he asked. We'll learn our state's dumb nickname over and over and over. Hickle and snickle pox, depressing, said Michael. I nodded. We have so much to look forward to. Chapter 18. If you can't beat 'em, join 'em and get beat. Pretty soon we were so mad we decided to take it out on other kids. That's right, we became the bullies. Well, we tried to. We figured everybody at school was afraid of the bullies, us included. So maybe if we were bullies, all the other kids would be so terrified of what we might do to them that they'd stop calling us potty mouth and stupid. But it didn't work out that way. Michael and me, worst bullies ever. We didn't know what we were supposed to do or how to do it. We couldn't tell a swirly-whirly from an atomic wedgie, a triple-nipple cripple from a raspberry rug burn. We even studied those signs they have all over the school, the ones that explain what bullying is. Stop bullying now. Examples of bullying. Hitting, kicking, other kinds of physical bullying, name-calling and teasing, spreading rumors, excluding others in a mean way, taking money or other belongings, sending mean emails. Do you think we're supposed to do all of this at, like, the same time? I guess. Bullies probably multitask. Should we start with ignoring others in a mean way? Works for me. We hung out on the playground and looked for kids who seemed like they wouldn't put up much of a fight. Small kids. Kids with glasses or those spiky dinosaur backpacks. Then we go over and ignore them in a mean way. Why are you ignoring me like that? Said our first victim, a tiny kid named Sherman. He didn't look like he weighed much more than a cat. It's what bullies do, I said. The whole school is a no-bullying zone, Buster, said Sherman. Consider this fair warning. Fair warning about what? I asked. I won't tolerate bullying, said Sherman. If I see something, I'm gonna say something. I might even do something. Michael got a pained look on his face. I think he had gas. Sherman thought he was a snarl. It sort of made the little guy snap. He screamed, "Hi-ya!" and leapt into a pretty awesome martial arts dance. Turned out Sherman goes to karate every day after school. Weekends, too. It also turned out that Michael and I ended up on our butts. Like I said, worst bullies ever.